I spent two glorious days exploring the magical city of Petra, and I can tell you safely that I was absolutely mesmerized by the end of 2 days. Due to the sheer size and vastness of the city, I definitely recommend spending at least 2 days to explore the sights and sounds of this lost city.
We stopped for a quick break. We could not eat breakfast, so we're just grabbing something to eat, and the spread looks delicious. This is at a restaurant which is right inside the petrol pump.
Inhabited since prehistoric times, this Nabatean caravan city, situated between the Red Sea and the Dead Sea, was an important crossroads between Arabia, Egypt, and Syria. Petra is half built, half carved into the rock, and is surrounded by mountains riddled with passages and gorges. Petra was once the thriving trade center and the capital of the Nabatean Empire between 400 BC and 106 AD. Only in the early 1800s did a European traveler disguise himself into a Bedouin costume to discover the mysterious city of Petra. In 1985, the Petra Archaeological Park was declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and in 2007, it was named as one of the new 7 wonders of the world.
That's where we started walking from. We've just reached midway, and can you see how much we've climbed to get here? And the best part is we still have a long way to go.
We're in the highest place of sacrifice in Petra. From here you can see the entire city of Petra. The view is quite incredible and the sun is just setting down.
So I guess it's the perfect time to be here.
Welcome. And welcome to Jordan. Welcome to Petra. We are a Bedouin, we live here. Except our friend here. You come as a guest, you live a friend. Welcome, India.
On the first day, we only explored Petra for 4 hours, but we were blown away and we couldn't wait to come back really early the next day, avoid the crowds and just soak in all of Petra all over again.
Finally at a restaurant to eat some food. We're at this restaurant called Alwan. There are some typical Jordanian food. I haven't tried something typical till now, so quite excited to see what the food is like. So yeah, just waiting for the food to arrive. Call for the shawarma meal. It consists of pickles, shawarma, fries and garlic cream. Garlic cream is the highlight of the dish. It's also inside the shawarma, but it tastes so good. The next dish that we're trying is a Jordanian speciality called maklube. It's very similar to Indian biryani or pulao. Not as spicy as the biryani, and it's upside down. So it's rice cooked with very less spices, just like how it's in the whole of the Middle East. Sliced potatoes, my favorite, and chicken. When you see it, you might feel like, you know, it doesn't have any flavor. This is so fika in Hindi. But when you actually have it, it's full of flavor. So if you're in Jordan next time or you have the opportunity to try it out, you should try it out. It's really nice.
Day 2 in Petra. We're going to explore the place a little more and do some interesting hikes. Before we head, it's time for breakfast. Let's see what this spread is like today.
So we have the rather spiced pita bread with lots of butter. It's like the regular pita bread, but just it has an additional seasoning of the sugar and mutton sauce. Super good.
We're at Bab al Sikh. This is the main entrance leading to Petra. The significance of this place is the 4 main blocks
which is the place where four members of the higher family were buried here in the ancient times. We're at the theater right now. It's the only theater in the world that can accommodate up to 4,000 people, and it's completely carved out of stone.
Hiking up to the monastery.
High above, overlooking the valley, is the impressive Aldair Monastery. A flight of 800 rock cut steps takes you there from the main site of Petra. Hidden in the hills, the monastery is one of the legendary monuments of Petra. Similar in design to the treasury, but far bigger, 50 meter wide and 45 meter high, it was built in the 3rd century BC as a Nabataean tomb.
Petra is also referred to as the Rose City because when the sunlight hits the rocks, it changes into a shade of rose. Made it to the base of the monastery, now heading back to leave Petra. We've finished exploring this place for the last 2 days and now it's time for us to head.
There are studies that suggest that the Nabataeans used the city of Petra to study astronomy and the position of the sun.
So our amazing Airbnb host Ahmad is serving us dinner in a typical Bedouin style today. We are seated on the ground.
So we have bread, we have a green based chicken curry and lots of rice and a fireplace to keep us warm. Really love the Bedouin type seating arrangement that they have kept for us. It's really wonderful when your Airbnb host goes out of the way to give you a true authentic experience.
The Bedouin people came from Arabia about 2,200 years ago, and from Arabia and Yemen. And you know the Quran book, my God, he said in Quran, وَمِنَ الْجِبَالِ يَنْحَتُونَ بِيُوتًا. The meaning the people from mountain have a house. Also in Saudi Arabia, you can find like this place. We call it Mada'in Saleh. Yeah, and all the origin, all the history of the Bedouins just moved from this area to another area. The original for all the Arab people is a Bedouin.
Okay.
Some of people now born in this city and another area, but if you look to the history, it's a Bedouin. We are a Bedouin. All the Arab people. To my house and to my country, it's the land of the hospitality. I wish you enjoy here. Inshallah, we'll meet soon.
For sure. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
With that, we're leaving Petra. It was a really, really nice experience staying with the local people yesterday, and I would really recommend you to do it if you're here. I really hope you enjoyed watching the video. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and I will see you again with a brand new video next time. Bye from Petra.
Bye, auntie. Bye. Thank you so much.